time in range tells you the entire story.
In the past, we had hemoglobin A1C that was like a 30,000 foot view, just an average of how you were doing, and it didn't matter if you were up or down. If it averaged out to a good level, the doctor would say you're doing fine.
We now know that not all hemoglobin A1Cs are created equal.
You can actually have two people with the same A1C, and one person's gliding along at the little hills that we like to see, not too much variation, and the other person's having really widely swinging blood sugars, but they have the same average, so they may have the same A1C.
So that number that we've been using for a long time was good in the sense we didn't have anything else. In the advent of continuous glucose monitors, we now have much better metrics, specifically time in range. Time in range refers to glycemic control between 70 and 180 milligrams per deciliter. It's what people without diabetes, we would expect their glucose readings to be, no matter what they're doing.
When you look at time in range, it's showing you not only where you are, what percent of time you're in the area that you want to be, but how much time you're spending out of those areas too.
When the person is sleeping, when they are eating, when they are not looking at their glucose level.
The more data we have, the better we can do.
Time in range simplifies the interpretation, the understanding of what technology provides.
To have that information at their fingertips anytime is really important.
When you're able to see, hey, Tom, you can't eat a whole bag of Doritos because your glucose goes too high after, you learn from that behavior.
They go from high to low, low to high, and here it is. Look what's happening. And that helps them understand better.
Time in range is how I define my confidence, and it's my goal to give this same confidence and peace of mind to my patients with diabetes.